You are out of your damn little pea-sized mind. What is wrong with you? Do you have any sense at all?
Okay.
Do you have any idea how to run an office?
Yes.
Every day you do something stupider than you did the day before.
That's,
and I think there's no possible way he can top that.
Okay.
But what do? You find a way, damn it, to top it. You are a professional idiot.
Mission failed. We'll get him next time.
So today, Activision and Sony announced that Modern Warfare will be getting an exclusive piece of content only on PlayStation for an entire year. That's right, PlayStation players will get exclusive content for an entire year. So in the new story trailer for Call of Duty Modern Warfare, if you watch the PlayStation version of the trailer, at the beginning and the end of it, it says, play Special Ops Survival Mode first on PlayStation 4, with a little asterisk, and down at the bottom it says, timed exclusive content until October 1st, 2020. That's over a year away from now. Like, just to put that into perspective, every single piece of previous Call of Duty exclusive content, right? Like, people even bring up the whole deal with how, oh no, Xbox players are just salty, and Xbox players got exclusive content before, and now it's PlayStation's turn. Okay? But Xbox never got content a year early. So, like, can you guys imagine back to any other Call of Duty game, right? Like, let's say Black Ops 2. Black Ops 2 had DLC first on Xbox. Imagine for Origins, right? If the Apocalypse DLC for Black Ops 2 released on Xbox, you know, in like in August of 2013, but it didn't release on PlayStation until August of 2014. You gotta wait a full year to play Origins on your PlayStation and PC. Imagine how much that would blow. But that's what they're doing here. They're taking out a piece, a content piece from the game, and they're limiting it to a specific platform for an entire year. And it's ridiculous that they do this because Call of Duty games are like yearly releases. So, by October 1st, 2020, Black Ops 5 is going to be like a couple weeks away from launch. So, basically, Xbox and PC players aren't going to be able to play Spec Ops mode until when Black Ops 5 comes out. And at that point, who cares? Just buy Black Ops 5 and just play that. So, they say that it's only in the survival mode within Spec Ops. They say that you get all the missions, everything else, all other pieces of content, the exact same time on Xbox, PS4, and PC. But it's only the survival mode that is exclusive to PlayStation until October 1st, 2020. And the community is absolutely like in uproar about this right now because this is insane. Like, there has been stuff like this before with Activision. This isn't the first time Activision's tried this bullcrap. It happened with Destiny, how, you know, for Xbox players, they had to wait a year to get content that was first on PlayStation. And, like, why? What, because Activision and Sony are in bed together? That means that, oh hey, you bought an Xbox. Well, that sucks. You guys are going to have to wait an entire year to play the same content that I can play on PlayStation. Like, what even is that? Right? Like, that's sure going to make people want to go and buy a PlayStation 4 because of all this stupid like garbage that Sony and Activision are pulling. Like, no. People are just not going to buy the game on Xbox then, right? And, like, that's the thing, is people are even canceling their pre-orders of the game because of this. So why is Activision giving the finger to their millions of players who buy the game on Xbox and PC? They do not care at all about those two platforms. They do not care one bit. And this is, like, the perfect example. I talked about this in my recent video, talking about the PlayStation Day 1 Advantage. We don't know what that is. I'm assuming this is probably what it is the advantage of being able to play survival for a year early. But I don't understand that, though. But it's, like, Activision is just giving the shaft to Xbox and PC players. And it's insulting. Like, why would they treat their player base like this? Two-thirds of your player base, and you're treating them like this? Hey, you bought the same $60 game as everybody on PlayStation? Well, that sucks. You're not going to be able to get the same amount of content as them. You paid the same price, but you don't get the same content. You get less content. Just let that sink in for a moment. You are paying $60 to get less content than somebody else paying $60. And one of the Infinity War developers even kind of talked about this. They touched on this on Twitter today. Somebody actually tweeted at him and said, "This game had so much potential, but the things about exclusives and people paying $60 only to have to wait to play the content they paid for is sickening. Look, you're a really good person, and I know you can't do certain things behind the scenes, but Activision is ruining your game." And he says, "Let's be honest, quote, ruining is an exaggeration. Survival is 1% of the game. The other 99% is simultaneous day and date across all platforms. I'd rather have everyone playing 99% of the content at the same time than 100% of the content sometime later." So I understand where he's coming from here. Like, the whole aspect of this is ruining the game, yes, that is an exaggeration. This, like, I've seen people post tweets and stuff and comments saying that, to be honest with you, like, the whole, like, survival, like, nobody's really going to be playing survival that much, right? It's going to be something you hop into, you play a couple games, and you get bored of, and you go and play, you know, the campaign, or you play multiplayer or something like that. Like, there's barely going to be anybody who even plays this at all. Everyone's just going to play it, like, once and then be done with it. So by not having it, it's not going to ruin the game. But then he does say that here that, you know, survival is just 1% of the game, that you still have campaign, multiplayer, and Spec Ops. You still have all the Spec Ops missions, you just don't have survival. But the thing I don't get about his reply here is that he says, you know, "I'd rather have everyone playing 99% of the content at the same time than 100% of the content sometime later." So he acts like, for some reason, if Xbox and PC got 100% of the content that PlayStation gets, it would happen later. That makes no sense. Can you guys explain to me in the comments down below how that makes any sense? How would Xbox and PC getting content delay all platforms getting the content? That makes no sense. If it's ready and it's the content is literally developed for PlayStation, it takes what, like 2 seconds to get it up and running on Xbox and PC? So what's the difference? His whole argument here in this last portion about having 99% of the content at the same time rather than 100% of the content later is dumb. Like, maybe he's talking about having, like, you know, 100% of the content, like, having everybody get survival, like, in October 1st, 2020. But that's not the case. 100% of the content would be having all the content, 100% of the content, on October 25th, 2019, when the game releases. Having survival on your Xbox, having survival on your PC, as well as your PlayStation. How is that going to delay the game, or, you know, going to get content later, just because it's on other platforms, too? But straight up, yeah, guys, that's the whole thing. This was now a stupid PlayStation state of play, and the, you know, Activision and Sony are just like, hey, giving the finger to everybody on Xbox and PC. So, I don't know. What do you guys think about this? I've seen a lot of people whining and complaining on Twitter, like, defending this, and being like, oh, no, well, you know, Xbox had exclusives before, and now it's PlayStation's turn. Okay, yeah, but that was always 30 days. Plus, Xbox and PC have experienced that too. Remember back with Black Ops 3 DLCs? That was a month exclusive on PlayStation. Just like how Black Ops 2's DLC was a month exclusive on Xbox. So, both platforms have experienced the same exclusivity BS. Exclusivity is garbage and it needs to go away. And then PC's been getting the shaft the whole entire time. PC has always had to wait. They've never gotten content first or at the same time as these other platforms. And 30 days was honestly awful, and everybody hated that. And then they finally improved it down to 7 days with Black Ops 4, which was definitely a step up. You know, and we thought that with this game, we were actually going to be able to get all content at the exact same time. That'd be fantastic. Wow, what a genius idea. But instead they're like, 7 days is way too short. And same with 30 days. Let's make it a year. So yeah, that's just how Activision feels about the Xbox and PC communities. And a lot of people are expressing how they feel back by canceling their pre-orders and stuff. So that is the controversy going around today. I don't know how Activision continues to do stuff like this. How there is constant controversy like this that just absolutely disrupts the game. Like, how do you guys constantly screw things up like this? How are you guys always messing things up? Right, the Gunfight Alpha was only available on PlayStation. Okay, well, that was, you know, strike one. Here we go, strike two, with this whole, you know, exclusive thing a year early on PlayStation. And then I'm sure they're gonna fill this game up with loot boxes and microtransactions, just fill it to the brim, trying to just absolutely milk everybody dry. And it just seems like Activision just can't help themselves from just absolutely ruining this franchise. This game sounded and looked awesome and amazing. We had great things like crossplay, cross progression, free DLC, a hopefully good PC port. I mean, we even have in like PC specific features like NVIDIA's ray tracing, tons of awesome stuff that made this game seem like it was going to be a really good game. And then Activision just can't help themselves from ruining it by announcing garbage like this and having just a giant, just absolute dumpster fire going on. But I don't want to crap on this Infinity War developer like too much. I do disagree with that second part of his statement, but he also did say in another one that it's, you know, it was a decision above the pay grades of a lot of Infinity Ward employees. Like, I'm sure the head studio guys at Infinity Ward probably had some sort of like say behind this, but mostly it's just Activision and Sony. You know, I'm sure that Activision had promised Sony some sort of exclusivity for this game, and then when they announced crossplay, they're like, oh, we can't have exclusive maps because that would break crossplay. So what are we going to have be exclusive? And Sony's like, hey, you guys promised us something exclusive. And apparently that's why we even got the Gunfight Alpha in the first place, was because Sony wanted something exclusive for this game that Xbox and PC couldn't have, or at least not for a while. And they got that with the Gunfight Alpha, but apparently it's not enough. And now they have to get an entire section of the game a year early. So that is the whole thing going on today, guys. I wonder what's going to happen tomorrow, what Activision's going to do next, and what the next controversy is going to be surrounding this franchise. Just so fantastic, man. I love this so much. Same with everybody else. But there you guys go. Thank you so much for watching. And let me know your guys' thoughts on this in the comments down below. Subscribe to the channel with notifications on. And I'll see you in the next video.